you tell us your name and what course you're involved with?
My name is Charles Coleman. I'm an assistant professor in the Aerospace Engineering Department at MIT, and I teach system engineering and the Unified Engineering course.
And can you tell us what's going on today for this Unified Engineering Aerial Competition?
Today we're running the 2004 Unified Aerial Competition. There are about 14 teams of five students each that are flying their airplanes and demonstrating their systems.
How does this relate to the rest of the Unified course?
Well, the system problems in labs serve two purposes within Unified Engineering. The first purpose, the laboratories, provide an opportunity for students to experimentally verify some of the theoretical principles they've learned in class. The second aspect of system problems allows us to implement our conceived design, implement and operate pedagogy. And so we have several exercises throughout the semester where students must actually design, build, and operate small systems.
Mm-hmm. And this is the CDIO component. Can you say more about CDIO?
Yes. CDIO stands for Conceive, Design, Implement, and Operate. It's a pedagogical framework that we've chosen as a overarching framework to teach engineering. And the principle behind this is we sort of want to reduce the gap between what engineers do in real life and what we teach in school. The facts of the matter are most people, once they graduate and for being practical engineers, spend most of their lives conceiving, designing, building, and operating things. So as we teach theoretical principles, basic engineering principles, we want students to be able to apply them in the framework that they would, much like in their careers.
Okay, can you describe what's going to happen today and what the students have done to prepare for this event?
Oh yes, that would be a lot of fun. So I've assigned the students to design a system, and I teach a simple decomposition of systems. It's not the only one, but I teach students that systems are composed of people, products, and procedures that have to operate together to deliver value. And you can sort of think of value as going in the opposite direction of money. So systems are fairly general. This breakdown works anywhere for Disney World, people, product, and process, lawyering, and even to things like the military. In particular, today they have about a set of four functional requirements. To build a plane, train a pilot and a crew, and the task is to fly two empty laps, land the plane, load it with anywhere between one or four eggs, and then fly as long as they can with their payload. Then they also have to minimize the amount of time that they spend on the ground and loading the eggs. So that's what's going to go on today. We're going to see how the students perform based on their estimates.
And how long have the students prepared for this?
Oh, the students have been working for approximately 9 weeks for about 4 hours per week, with five people per team, and with training from us and various materials and supplies.
Well, any predictions about how it's going to go? Are we going to see a lot of spilled eggs, do you think?
I hope we don't see a lot of spilled eggs. One of the learning objectives of the course is, for me, is for every student, every group to have a successful systems building experience. So a broken egg is not necessarily a bad thing. You learn how to build systems by building systems. I think a unique aspect about this part of the course is that you can actually learn a lot from your failures.
So in other words, you can't learn to build aircraft without breaking some eggs.
True, that is true.
Okay, well thanks for your time and thanks for sharing your materials with OpenCourseWare.
Yep, thank you.